It's RW here in the shop. I'm making one of my grave digger acrylic plunge daggers for a client, and I'm going to put some select figured black limba on the handle. And so I wanted to show you sort of the process. First of all, when I get a really nice looking piece of exotic, I usually save a section of it, and so I can get those interesting parts out later and use them for detail work like this. And what's interesting is you might think, okay, yeah, you could just cut that right down in half and flip it and you'll have two nice pieces. Well, actually, it's not the case, because you can see the other side of that is not that exciting. And if you were to flip this out on the outside, still pretty neat, not as cool as that. So the only way to really get that is just to go along the length of the plank, and then you hinge it, basically. So from the side, okay, at least on one side, you're going to have this really wonderful grain pattern that's like a mirror. And on the other side, close, but no cigar. You know it. But it's not critical. It's just to make it nice, okay? So that's me selecting material for the T-handle. And you can kind of see where I want that long stripe with the embedded material in it. I want that on the T. So we're basically going to be using like that much of it, right in there. Very nice. This is my router template that I created for safety, right? So you can run the piece without, you know, worrying about your hand getting into the router blade. And this will get stuck down onto that. And then eventually, after I've profiled it and everything, I'll stick it on there. All right, so here's the basic thing, right? It's got no round over on it yet. So I go through three round over bits to get it to full round over. Right? And then I've got my hole drilling jigs on this side if I want to attach it with holes. But I'm thinking about doing something a little different. Okay, so that's what it looks like after it's been profiled and rubbed down with quadruple aught steel wool. And you can see there's an amazing little ribbon right underneath that brown stripe. You can see the embedded material. This is really an outstanding little piece of black limba here. So, got the handles done. So what I've been working on is working up from 220 to 600. And this is what 600 looks like. And now I'm going to buff it out on my buffing wheel here. This is kind of dangerous, actually. Small objects like this are easy to catch in the wheel and then they get flung. And also, if you don't have a light touch, what can happen, you can change your shape, especially real thin edge like this on this plunge dagger. Very easy to change the shape of it. So you got to work with an extremely light touch. I've left one side unpolished. You can kind of see the edge, how that looks, and how that looks. And then you can see this has been polished. This is not. And I got a little more to go on this. Don't want to mess it up. So we'll set up another wheel and take it from there. Yeah, so this is what a fully polished one looks like. It still has some schmutzer on it from the buffing wheel, which I'll clean off with Novus and all that. Got this polished to optical clarity. Okay, you can see right through it. Okay. And preserved the profile of the blade. Okay, didn't change that in any way, shape, or form. Okay. So it's beautiful. So this has really been a fiddly bit of work. It's kind of dangerous work to take something sharp and pointy like this and have it in a wheel where it could get hooked and flung into you, or you're doing like this, it could be flung down. So took my time with that, got that done. So where am I at now? Well, I got to apply the wood to the acrylic, and my usual method is to put it in with like all thread rod basically, and then snip it off and grind it, and it looks like pens. And if I was in some kind of a big rush and I just wanted to get it done, I could just screw some on there. But what I'd like to do is glue them on, because they're so pretty, and it just seems a shame to have hardware over top of that lovely little figure in the wood there. And it just seems like it really needs to be just glued on there. So I've got some JB liquid metal. The reason I chose the liquid metal is from me using it in the past, it seems a lot different than other epoxies, like urethane type epoxies. Basically, if you put urethane epoxy all over this, you could just grab the edge of it and flake it right off of it. It would just pop off it. You could almost use this like a mold, because it's so shiny and smooth that there's no key, there's no tooth for the epoxy to grab anything. And it can't saturate into it, it can't grab it. But what I found about this liquid metal is that it just seems to be a different animal. It takes a super long time to cure, though. That's the downside of it, like 24 hours at room temperature. You can't really accelerate it much. But what I've done is I've glued a couple little scraps just onto the shiny part. I want to see, and I've left some smears on the shiny part to see how that flakes off. Here's just a rough sawn edge. I wanted to see how that grabbed. And then the part that I'm really concerned about is I've taken a piece of the material just like the handle material. I've roughed up the sheet and I've stuck them together with the JB Weld, and I've squished it really hard so that there's almost no, as you can see, almost no glue line. So you won't see any JB Weld when this is all done, said and done, you won't even see it. Except maybe looking through at gray, you'll just see gray at the back instead of wood. But they're such nice little pieces, and I just would love to show them off entirely. And I think I can if I glue them on. So that's the plan. So I'll have to come back to this, okay? So I basically got the project well in hand. I told my client, give me about 48 hours. So I started my 48 hours this morning. So I'm figuring tomorrow morning I'll know whether or not that glue's good. So project's well in hand, but I'm kind of having to pause here for a little experiment because I've never actually tried this before, and I thought it looked so much nicer. It was worth taking a day to find out how that works.